Hi, my name is Alice, and I'm an engineer on the Glass software team. After our initial launch in the United States, Glass is expanding to other countries. I'd like to show you how to make your GDK Glassware support more languages and therefore reach more users. Here are some basic techniques for localizing Android GDK Glassware. First, make sure all visible text is declared in a base strings.xml file. You can then refer to each string by its name in your Java code. It's good practice to include a comment for each string so your translators have more context on how it's used. Once your translations come back, simply put them into the corresponding values directory for that language. You can also have different versions of images, audio, and video files for different locales, but it's better if the same icon can just apply to all languages. That's pretty much all that's needed. Piece of cake. Now, let's look at some issues you might run into. One common oversight is using hard-coded strings in the code. This will lead to untranslated text. Another problem is translations that are too long, causing overlapping text. You can avoid this by suggesting a character limit in your original string's definition, so translators know not to exceed it. One more thing to look out for is parameters in text. It may be tempting to simply concatenate substrings together. In this example, received at followed by the variable 2 followed by a clock. But in the Chinese translation, 两点钟收到, the time variable moved to the front of the sentence instead. As shown here, the solution is to use placeholders in your string definition so that the entire sentence gets translated as a whole. That concludes how GDK Glassware can be localized. Once your glassware is ready, remember to submit it to the Glass team for review. We look forward to seeing your submissions, and thank you for watching.